Hi, Mom. Yeah, no, can you pick up Chris after school? Yeah, I'm at the doctor's.
Mrs. Harris?
Describe your symptoms.
Hang on. Stress, headaches, nausea. Well, I work on Saturdays.
And how long has this been?
Equanimity. Balance your lifestyle.
Make sure you take any car you're buying for a test drive. Open up the hood, check the trunk, look around the vehicle, check underneath the dashboard for frayed wires, watermarks, any smells that cause you concern, and then finally, make sure you ask for a vehicle history report. See if there are any problems in that car's past that may cause you pause or create problems further down the road.
That sounds really good. I've got a Facebook question for you, Larry. I told my audience you were coming, and boy, did the questions pour in about lemon cars. One of them is that what kind of rights do I have if I buy a car and it malfunctions after I purchased it?
Well, the unfortunate thing is that this is an excellent example of an ounce of prevention being worth a pound of cure. While there may be legal remedies to help you if you become the victim of one of these frauds, it is far better, far easier if you do your homework ahead of time. And before you lay down your hard-earned money, make sure the seller answers all your questions. Getting your car checked by a mechanic and asking for a CARFAX report are really like your 1-2 punch to avoiding getting ripped off.
Okay. Now, when you go to the dealership or to a person, do you need to say these things up front?
I would absolutely make sure you go, whenever you're buying a car, with a list of the questions that you want to have answered before you buy the car. You want to make sure that that seller can tell you about the car's history and show you a vehicle history report. You want to have an inspection performed by a qualified mechanic. You're going to want to talk about how you're going to pay for the car, about the financing. All of those things need to be checked off your list before you lay down your hard-earned money to purchase that vehicle. So really, buyer beware, you have the right to have all your questions answered. Don't feel pressured into buying a car. And if you ever come across a seller who refuses to answer your questions or doesn't answer the questions the way you think that they should be, walk away. You have the right to walk away from any car before you buy. There are so many great deals out there. And if you need to find a great used car, you can start at the allnewcarfax.com. We've got millions of vehicles listed for sale there, all with CARFAX vehicle history reports, so you can quickly find the cars you want and avoid the ones you don't.
All right, I'll take the last Facebook question, you guys. You guys got too many for me. I bought the question is, how safe is it buying a car online?
Buying a car online is a great option, but just like everything else, you're going to want to make sure that you don't get ripped off. Two things that we suggest if you're shopping online: make sure you see the car before you buy. Don't send the seller money before you see the car. And two, check the paperwork thoroughly. Make sure the seller is the person they say they are, and make sure the car matches all the information in the paperwork that you receive. You're going to want to make sure that you don't become the victim of an online fraud, some con man selling you a piece of junk and you being out $10,000 to $15,000.
Well, Larry Ganache, you're going to be my car expert of the day. You're a great way to end a Friday. Where would you send my audience online to find out more information?
Well, I would start at CARFAXX.com. We have over 700 people working hard to gather the information you need to answer the questions you have when you're buying, shopping, or owning your vehicle.
Well, we love this information from CARFAXX. Thank you so much, Larry. Have a great weekend.
Thank you so much.